Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today's video we're going to be talking about Volkswagen and their kind of like a collapse of the German market in terms of producing their vehicles at an affordable rate. They're looking at closing a couple of their plants there. We're going to be talking about how that is directly tied with energy costs and how that also ties in with Bitcoin mining. How if you cannot produce cars at an effective lower rate, how are you going to produce Bitcoins at a good cheap rate? That's what today's video is going to be about. You see me out here in the park. A little change in our dynamics here for creating videos. We're walking and talking, so hope you guys like these type of videos. And before we get started, Bitcoin saves your wealth and Jesus Christ saves your soul. All right, so let's get started here. Let's start off with the article. Today's article is from Reuters. And this article is titled, Volkswagen considers historic German plant closure and cost drive. A couple of bullet points is what we're going to be looking at today. VW considers one car plant, one component plant in Germany obsolete. Works Council. Cost-cutting drive at namesake brand must be extended. VW management compelled to end job security program. Workers Council promises fierce resistance to plans. And then shares up 1.2. No, they're up obviously because Volkswagen is considering shutting down some plants, cutting costs, things like that, and most likely shipping a lot of their manufacturing out of Germany. So the question is, why is Germany doing this? I thought Germany was a great place to manufacture things, right? It was really cheap. It was one of the biggest economies in the world. I think it was, number three or four, like a decade ago. So what happened to Germany? Why is it not so profitable to create cars or to manufacture cars in Germany? What happened in the last couple of years? One big event. What was that? You guys remember? It was like really big. It was in the news. Biden was talking about how great it was and how it's going to create democracy and, everyone's going to be freer and all that stuff. And, and Germany was going to be better off. Remember all that talk? What was that big event? That's right. It was the Ukraine war. So how's that going for you, Germany? How is that going for you? How is that helping out German people getting, better paid jobs or keeping their jobs, actually? In this situation, it's actually just keeping their jobs. How is that going for you? Now, obviously, the answer is not good. VW would not be closing down their plants if everything was going great. They would be opening up new plants, especially in Germany. Keep things closer to headquarters. And if you were making a lot of money off of your cars, you'd be able to, keep everything going. But that changed. That changed. And then what other event happened in Germany or Germany's energy? What other event happened in the past year and a half that really changed things? Germany was getting really, really cheap gas and, everything was going pretty good. What happened? What was that one big event? It was like an explosion and then something happened with the energy markets and all that. Remember the gas prices went up in the United States. What was that event? Oh, that was Nord Stream 2. Remember that? Nord Stream 2. And Nord Stream 2 was what? It was a gas pipeline from Russia to Germany. And Germany used that gas to manufacture their cars, to give heating to all their plants, to use it for electricity production. All that stuff was with Nord Stream 2, right? Now that's gone. Now, what does this have to do with Bitcoin? It has a lot to do with Bitcoin. Energy is one of the hugest, if not probably the most important aspect of Bitcoin. You need to have cheap energy. Now, if Volkswagen can't afford to make cars in Germany because energy prices are too high, then obviously you can't mine in Germany. That takes away the ability for Germans to actually run a mining farm. And that's what we see all the time. People from Europe, they say, I can't even run a farm here. The energy prices are too high. I can't set up my farm in Germany. I can't do it in France. I can't do it in Spain. I can't do it anywhere in the European Union because the European Union doesn't have really the resources to, in terms of commodity resources like oil and gas and all that stuff. They don't have that. On top of that, they're against nuclear. So can't have the gas, can't have the oil, you can't have the nuclear. What can you have? Well, you can have bankruptcy. That's what Germany is going to be heading into if they don't change course and come back and start purchasing commodities from whoever sells it at the cheapest price. I mean, if the Germans care about the German economy, that's what they're going to do. But it looks like they don't. And again, back to Bitcoin. So with Bitcoin, all of those European countries, they are stuck, right? They can't mine Bitcoin in their countries. They just can't. They have to look for a different country out there where they can invest their funds. If they want to build out their farm, they have to go out to the United States. They have to go to, ironically, Russia. They have to go to Kazakhstan. They have to go to maybe Georgia. They have to go to Iran, ironically again. All the countries that have cheap energy, they need to go there. And one of those energy rich countries is the United States. And that's where our data centers are based in. Our crypto LLC data centers are in the United States, by the way. If you're looking to build a farm, you're looking to buy miners, we have all of that available, crypto LLC. And again, they are at affordable rates. You can build out your farm in the United States at a good rate. Can't do that in Germany. Can't do that in basically any of the Western European countries. And again, going back to Volkswagen. So with this whole situation of Volkswagen, you can kind of see an implosion of a giant car manufacturer. Now, the way out of this situation is obviously for Germany to come back, you know, to Russia and be like, you know what, let's buy that gas, right? Let's buy that oil. Let's get back to business, because obviously German interests come first and we should care about Germans, and that's what they should do. But will they do that? That's a different question that we do not know. And you can see that this can repeat itself with Bitcoin mining, right? If you have a country that wants to ban Bitcoin mining, which did happen in China, and China does have cheap electric rates, a lot of those miners left and they went searching for what? They went searching for a country that allows Bitcoin mining and that has a cheap electric rate. And a lot of those miners, they went to the United States. They went to the United States. Why did they do that? Because it has cheap electricity, it has decent infrastructure, it has safety, it has all of that. So they know that, hey, if I'm gonna pump $100 million into a United States data center, nothing's gonna happen to it, right? No one's going to steal the miners, no one's going to destroy the infrastructure, and I have a good electric rate, and I can continue to mine. So I can take all my Chinese miners that I was mining in China and ship them to the United States, and they'll be fine. And they were right, they are fine. They are totally fine, they can mine in the United States. But for countries like Germany and France, like maybe they never had that option. They never could mine in Germany or France. They always had to look for another country out there to ship their miners to build out their data centers and all that stuff. So you can kind of get some parallels here with Volkswagen situation and learn a bit or two. Now, not really talking to people outside of Germany or outside of the European Union, because there are a lot of those countries do have cheap electricity, but the European Union is just crazy. It's just crazy out there. You cannot do anything out there. And here comes another one tumbling down. Another company, a great company, by the way. I like the design of the Volkswagens. They look pretty good. So pretty decent company. They also have not only Volkswagen, I think they own like Bentley, and I don't know if they own Rolls Royce, but and then they own, who else? Do they own BMW? No, they don't own BMW. I think that's, Daimler owns BMW and Mercedes. But I think they own Porsche, Volkswagen, some of those. They own all of those, so imagine that, right? You can't do it. By the way, another bullet point on that article is the fact that they're going to be ending a lot of the bonuses, a lot of the, I guess it's probably healthcare. I don't know how Germany runs their whole social system down there, but if these workers lose their jobs, they're going to be losing a lot. They're going to be losing, I think, in some situations, their pensions. They might be not getting their full pensions or losing some of it. They might be losing their healthcare. And maybe their premium healthcare, whatever they were getting at those companies, obviously they're losing their job and all of that. And it's really sad to see that happening. And all of that is because someone in the European Union said, you know what? Cheap energy is not that important. It's not that important. Let's just buy it somewhere else. And here we go. There goes Volkswagen. Now, one way they could fix it, go back, buy it for cheap. The other way they could fix it is to ship all the jobs from Volkswagen to a different country. That's another alternative they can do. They can ship all those jobs to Mexico to Asia, you know, like ship them out there somewhere. But what does that do? That just prevents the collapse of Volkswagen, you know, and the shareholders and the CEO and all the board members, they all stay afloat, they all make money. But what about the Germans? They're out of a job. What about the Germans? Is no one thinking about the Germans? No one cares about the Germans? I mean, obviously Biden doesn't care about the Germans with the whole pipeline thing. When are the Germans gonna start thinking about Germans, right? When are the French gonna start thinking about the French? When are the Italians gonna start thinking about the Italians? And everyone should be thinking about themselves and how to take care of themselves. And that's exactly what Bitcoin is all about. Taking care of yourself, being responsible, right? It's your money, your keys. You do what you want with it, it's yours. No one can take it, no one can steal it, no one can confiscate it from you. No one can touch it, untouchable. No one can print it. You know, it's not a dollar, it's not worthless paper, it's Bitcoin. And yeah, it's crazy out there. Guys, hope you guys like these types of videos. We got a nice green grass out there. If I zoom in a little closer here, it's kind of muddy down here at the bottom. But out there, it's all these moles, by the way, and they're just creating all these holes. They ruined it. They ruined somewhat of this nice green grass out here on the opposite side. Do have nice thick trees, shrubs, really, really good stuff out here. So if you guys are living out in the desert, that sucks for you. But hey, if you got cheap energy, that's pretty good. Well, that's gonna be it for this one. Hope you guys like it. Until next time, goodbye.